So today we are talking about cookie notices. If you are running a website, there are very high chances that your website is setting up some cookies on your visitor's computer. It can be for different purposes. It can be for saving login information, tracking some shopping data for the card user added on your website, or there can be different purposes setting cookies on your user's computer. By GDPR law in EU and some other countries, from 2018, it is required that you take consent of a user that you are setting up cookies on their computer. So today we'll see how you can create a cookie notice just like this one, that you can show user that you are using cookie and they can accept it and they can decline it. They can also go to privacy page to read everything about the cookies you are set on their computer. Before we move forward, I would like to tell you, in this channel I give a lot of important tips and tricks that how you can create your website, how you can manage your website, and how you can add a lot of useful functionality on your website. Not just this, I tell you how you can make your website more faster and more secure. If you are new here and you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I highly recommend you to subscribe to my channel right now and give this video a thumbs up if you like it, because when you like it, it can reach a lot of other audience who can be also benefited with all the useful content I'm making here on YouTube. So let's go into my screen and see how we can add this cookie notice on your website so your website is compliant with GDPR law. And it is a very right thing to do, because people think you are very serious about their privacy and they will trust you more if you have the cookie notice on your website. So let's go into my screen and see how we can implement cookie notice on your website. Okay, so first of all, you need to log in into WordPress dashboard. Then from left sidebar, hover on plugins and then click add new. So now search for the plugin called cookie notice. I want to tell you that there are a lot of plugins for cookie notice, but this plugin we are going to use is a special plugin because it is very easy to use. It has all the options what you need. It has option that you can customize the text depending on the region or the languages. That's why I choose this plugin. So the plugin is the third plugin, which is cookie notice for GDPR and CCPA by DeFactory. So now we're going to install this plugin. So click on install now. Once the plugin is installed, click on activate. Okay, now when the plugin is activated, you can find this plugin into setting in your left sidebar and then cookie notice. So I click on cookie notice and you can see this has just one page configuration. It doesn't have a lot of complicated setup to do. That's why I choose this plugin. It is so easy to use and it will do all the stuff what you need. It can allow user to give consent. It allow user to revoke the consent. So this is the notice. This is the default that we use cookies to ensure that we give you best experience on your website. If you continue this site, we'll assume that you're happy with it. You can change this text with anything what you want. And then you can set up the button text if you want to say yes, or you can say okay also. And then you can enable the privacy policy link. If you uncheck this option, there will be no privacy policy link like I show you here in the example. Here there's a privacy policy link. When somebody click it, they will go to the privacy policy page. I already created this privacy policy page on my website where you can write all the details about privacy policies, cookie notice and GDPR law. So you can, if you want, you can enable this link. I recommend you to enable this link because this is a very good thing that people can know about your website privacy policy. And then yeah, refuse content. If you enable this option, you can give the user to possibly refuse the third party non-functional cookies. For example, this one, people can say no, they don't want to set cookies on their computer. And then you have revoke consent option. For example, if somebody say yes, you can set up cookies. After they will be shown this option, they can revoke their previous consent. If they were agree with it, they can revoke it. They can be disagree. If they were disagree before, they can be agree and they revoke their old consent and give you a new consent. I'll show you everything in a minute, how it works. And then you can write the text for revoke consent also. And then there's some script blocking. This is for advanced users. You can leave this section. And then you have some options, reloading, on scroll, on click. If you want to enable the reload the page after cookie notice accepted, you can check this option. If you want to enable to accept the notice when user scrolls, you can check this option. If you want to enable the accept the notice on any click on the page, you can check this option. And then you have accepted expiry. I just set it to infinity and then rejection expiry to 1 month. And then your option to script placement, header or footer. I'll suggest you to keep this in footer because it will make your site more faster. But if you cannot see this cookie notice on your website, there must be some plugin conflict. So just you can use this in header also. And then you have deactivation option. If you enable this, when you deactivate the plugin, all the data set up by this plugin on your website will be deleted. And then you have Corona banner. It is not required. I don't know why they set up this. I will not display this option. So we'll go back to design. Now there's a position where you want to display a cookie notice. You want to display on the top of your website or on the bottom of your website. And then you can choose the animation. You want a fade style. You want a slide. Then you can decide the button style, if you want light theme or dark theme. Then you can add some button class. If you want to add some CSS, you can add a class here so that you can target the specific button. Then you have text color and bar color. And then you have opacity. If you just do this less, it will be more transparent. So once you're done, click on save changes. So now I'll open my website and show you. Okay, you can see here, there's a notice about cookies, that we are setting cookies on user's computer. If they continue to use this site, we assume that they will be happy with it. Now user can say yes. And now because we activated the revoke consent option, so now it will be always shown here. So when user want, they can revoke their consent. And then this message will be shown up again. Otherwise, if user say no, now they don't want to give you the consent that you can set up cookies on their computer. So they said no. But now if they want, they can revoke the consent also. And there will be option for them to accept the cookies again. And then your privacy policy. So once somebody click on privacy policy, they will reach to the privacy policy page. You can set up any page from your website to be your privacy policy page. So did you see it was so easy to set up cookie consent on your website for your visitors? And I recommend you to set up this cookie notice because it will make your website look serious and people think that you care about them. I'm sure you care about a website visitor, but it is a very nice way to interact with your audience and make them understand that how seriously you take their privacy. I hope you like the video. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Because when you like the video, YouTube will recommend this video to a lot of audience who are looking for this kind of knowledge, what I'm sharing here on YouTube. So thank you so much. See you in another video. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, subscribe it right now. Have a nice day.